11 News reporter John Sherman joins us live from the newsroom with the latest on that. John?
Well, Marianne, there were only four families in this suit, but the impact on them from the MTBE has been significant. One family has been drinking bottled water exclusively since 2003. Tonight, this is settled, but people out in Westminster still have lots of questions.
The neighborhoods around the intersection of Route 140 and Suffolk Road in Westminster is filled with families. But since 2003, families like the Lockwoods have been concerned about the water they drink. A gas tank underground at the Jiffy Mart station owned by Tevis Oil leaked MTBE into the ground.
It's scary. Yeah, I mean, it's amazing that they don't have higher standards, even back in the 70s and 80s, to contain these chemicals. It's just, it's scary because you look around a lot of neighborhoods, they have a local gas station. How many more problems are there that we don't know about?
A Carroll County jury awarded four families affected by the leak $400,000 total to be split among them. It has been an emotional issue for all the families living here.
The people who live closest to the gas station are angry about it. And the people who live a little bit further away like me are just sort of curious, hey, you know, how much is this going to affect me, my health, my family's health, my property values? So it's been a whole range of emotions.
The Maryland Department of the Environment found the spill was traced to the gas station, but Tevis Oil argued at trial the leak was coming from a nearby junkyard, not the gas station.
People have been damaged, their property values have been damaged, and their health has been damaged. So I'm not sure how monetarily you put a value on that.
The concern for this parent isn't just what's the impact of what we know. It's also what's to come for the families most affected.
You can't assign a monetary value to that. You just don't know what's going to happen in the future with them. It's scary.
The biggest award went to the family closest to the spill. They'll get $230,000 of the $400,000. The other three families will split the rest. Reporting live, John Sherman, WBAL-TV 11 News.